I am painting this hutch. It's actually going to be a reproduction of one that I did before, that I used the Rose Celebration transfer from Redesign with Prima, and I painted this in a layers of blue. So I'm using Wise Owl's Vintage Duck Egg as the base. It's kind of, it's this color here, so you can see it's like a light blue with a little bit of a grayish undertone to it. I'm also using Robin's Egg, which is a brighter blue color. And then Grecian Clay, which is like a dark gray. And that's going to be layered on top as well. I have already prepped this hutch. It's been sanded, and then I primed it with a little bit of Rust-Oleum's spray matte primer. You don't need a lot or to cover it completely, but this just makes it also easier to paint and less layers needed to cover up the wood color. So, and I'm just starting out with my vintage duck egg. Color. The Wise Owl paint is thinner in consistency because it self-levels so that you don't get brush strokes as much as you would with a chalk-based paint. So if you're looking for something that is smoother in texture, then this would be the right paint for you. Sorry, there's a little bit of a paint drip over there. So my brush is damp, that's why it looks a bit more watery than usual, but I'm using my Klingon brushes, which you store with water so you keep the brushes in water when you're not using them. I'm gonna work on the bottom part of the hutch first. And you can see when it's wet, it's slightly darker than what it looks like when it's dried. Sometimes paints don't look, or the actual color is not what it looks like while it's still wet. So you want to test out the color to get the most accurate shade of it. As it dries, it will become a lighter blue. I'm just using the widest brush that I have too, because this is a large area to cover. So it's easier just to use a large flathead brush that picks up paint more, so you're not doing as many brush strokes and dipping your paint back and forth. Just make sure these drips don't dry. painting this bottom. I'll get into the crevices too. All of these side areas. This under lip right here. And when you do it in thinner layers, it takes less time to dry as well. Which is a plus because watching paint drying isn't the funnest part of painting. And the thinner layers also give you smoother finish as well. So depending on the look that you're going for, you may want it to look like you may not mind the brush strokes because you're doing more of a blended look or a more rustic look. That dry before I do the next layer. Otherwise, I just end up dragging the paint around, and that doesn't really do anything except make it more work for me. So I let that dry. Just gonna move on to the top now. It's a fairly large hutch. And then I have my mister. I always have a water mister spray to use for when the paint starts getting a little bit thick because of the buildup of the paint onto the brush and it drying a little bit. So you want I want the paint to go on thinly. I'm not worried about the glass because I'm actually going to be using a scraper to get the paint off without scratching the glass. You can tape it off, of course, too, but I just find this to be the easiest way for me without wasting too much tape. And it's hard to get the paint in all the crevices when it's on too thick. It's easier when it's a bit wet to get it into all the little areas. When it's on thickly, it's more difficult. Just misting the surface. On my trolley cart, so I'm not bending down so much. I'm just misting the surface. Okay, misting that a bit. The brush gets a little heavy on the wrist. Okay. Alright, so let me move on to the bottom and let the top dry a bit now. Adding more of the vintage duck egg paints. You can see as it dried, it did turn a lighter color than when it is applied wet. It to go on nice and thin. Just gonna mist my brush a little bit too since I got it dry. Right, and now here's the fun part. It is time to do some blending and layering. So I'm using a bit of the Grecian clay. You can see it's kind of darkish. So I wanna like lighten it up a bit. It's getting a little wash in the middle. Just doing a light wash of it. I dipped it in some Robin's Egg Blue to lighten it up a bit. And with blending, it always looks rougher at the beginning than when you are actually finished. So with layering and blending, water is your friend. You want plenty of water at hand. And this is the Grecian clay from Wise Owl that I'm using. Just to play along the surface here. Now I'm going to be using some of the Robin's Egg Blue. It's a very pretty light blue color. And clean up the edges here. To do this while the surface is fairly wet still. I let my base layer dry completely, so that way when I blend, it's not just dragging the paint around. So just doing some misting here. And all right, and then add more of the Robin's Egg to this side. Gonna keep the surface damp. I'm using my Wise Owl Shorty brush. I like these because my wrists always start hurting after a bit when I'm been painting for some time, and these brushes are nice and light and not as hard on my wrist as some of the other brushes can be because the handles are so heavy after a while. When you've been painting for a few hours, it does start to take its toll. And then if you have arthritis, you know, or things like that, it's nice to have a lighter brush so that you can paint more easily. All right. So just going for a layered look that doesn't seem obvious until I list all the colors I'm using. Sometimes I like to go a bit more subtle with what I'm doing. But I don't want something to look flat. So just to give it some depth. Add a bit of the Robin's Egg right here too, and this just kind of highlights some of the areas because it's much lighter, so it kind of brings the lighter areas up front, especially when contrasted with a darker color. really easy to blend with the chalk synthesis paint, especially because it's not as thick as your typical chalk paints. It makes it easier to blend too. To be generous with the water misting. Highlighting these areas right here, the cabinet doors. This is also where I will be applying the Rose Celebration Transfer as well. So it always looks cool to have a bit of color interplay for the background when you're using it. I'm just adding a little bit more of the vintage duck egg around. Lighten up the gray a little bit. With the hutch that I'm trying to create the same design with, it actually had top drawers along with the cabinet on the bottom, and this one does not. So I'm trying to do a little bit of the gray on the top like I did with that one. So very similar color scheme, but not exactly the same. In all the areas. Okay, then let's add some robin's egg to the top of this ledge as well. So I'm just kind of using the robin's egg as like a highlighting the ledge right here. So you can see how the bit of lighter blue stands out. So I keep adding this. And I just love layering because it's so, you just keep adding on the colors until you get the look that you want, and it's not complicated at all. Paint is so forgiving that you can pretty much fix anything and just keep going until you get what you like. So there's really no pressure when it comes to blending. It's actually sometimes the clean finishes that I struggle with, because you can see every little imperfection when it comes to those. So sometimes the simplest ones are the hardest to do. Just add a little bit exterior right here as well. Let's see, where's my mister? Now I'm going to be moving to the top part of the hutch here. I'm going to be adding the robin's egg blue, just like I did on the bottom of the cabinet, with the layering effect. And so you can actually see how the vintage duck egg does have undertones of blue when you're contrasting it with a truer blue, bright blue color. You can notice the different tones that you may not have noticed before. Just like when you have different shades of white, they all look white, but until you put them next to each other, you can spot the slight, minute shade differences in the whites and the undertones there. Roughly getting it on the outside. I'll be adding more of the duck egg to the interior. And then I'll be adding actually a slight shade of green, a mint green, for more contrast as well in a bit. just really, I'm trying to make the raised areas pop. A little bit of drip there. A bit messy right now, but I'll be refining it as I continue blending with the different colors of paint. The blue up here. duck egg. Clean up the inside a little bit. Something. Okay, so what I have here is the Wise Owl's patina glaze. It is a light, extremely light blue color. It's a greenish, it's like a greenish blue color that's like sea glass. I'm going to be using this glaze on some of the top areas. So I'm using the mister. The glaze is more thinner than the paint. So it really lightens up the colors that are going on already. I'll layer a little bit of that. I kind of want it to blend more, so that's why I'm adding on the tuna glaze. To the top. I'm just kind of getting it all over surface. This way it doesn't look so top heavy with what I'm doing. Egg to the sides here as well. So I'm just going to keep adding the colors until I get it the way that I like it. So adding a bit more robin's egg here. So you can see it's getting gradually lighter, which is the true color of what I did last time. I'm gonna go ahead and put some of the glaze on the bottom as well. Dry brushing, but I need this part to stand out a bit, and then make the bottom area a tad bit lighter than what I had it. Down there. Add some of the duck egg to the bottom again. I'm doing some of the glaze on the bottom now. Putting it layered on there. I'm going to add a bit of where did it go? tiny bit of the glacier blue. This is more of a sky blue. So I'm going to add a tiny bit of that on. I think I'm good with that. I'm going to let it dry, and then I'll be adding perhaps a gray driftwood wax to give it some more gray tones. And then I will let this dry, and I'll be adding on the Rose Celebration. Oops, Rose Celebration. Transfer to this. As well. Just trying to bring some lightness to this area. adding layers forever, but stop here.